Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you directivity of antenna in great details, and at last I'll be solving one very interesting problem based on directivity of antenna. So first of all, I'll be explaining you what is directivity of antenna and how to calculate directivity of antenna. See, directivity of antenna is radiation intensity of given antenna in given direction with respect to radiation intensity of isotropic source. So if you want to calculate directivity of antenna, then directivity is D, that is radiation intensity of given antenna with respect to radiation intensity of isotropic source. So here we can calculate directivity of antenna, that is radiation intensity of antenna, let us say that is U, and radiation intensity of isotropic source, let us say that is U of ISO. So here with this calculation of radiation intensity with respect to radiation intensity of isotropic source, one can calculate directivity of antenna. Now here further simplification of this equation can be done, as if you have an idea about how to identify radiation intensity of isotropic source. See, radiation intensity of isotropic source, that one can calculate based on power radiated by antenna. In my earlier videos, I have explained this radiated power by antenna. See, radiated power by antenna, that is solid angle integration of radiation intensity of antenna. So if you do solid angle integration of radiation intensity, then you can identify radiated power. Now if you talk about isotropic source, then isotropic source radiates equally in all the direction. Let me explain you how. See, if you have isotropic source over here, if you have isotropic source over here, then it will be going to radiate equally in all direction. So here isotropic source radiates equally in all direction. So you can say radiation intensity of isotropic source, that is constant over here, right? That is constant over here with respect to solid angle. And as if you talk about radiation pattern of isotropic source, so that will be sphere over here, right? So radiation pattern of isotropic source, that will be sphere. So here, if you want to simplify this radiated power equation, then one can simplify that as per P radiated, that is equals to this U, that is constant for U ISO. So you can take U ISO outside, and you need to have solid angle integration for sphere. And for sphere, solid angle integration is how much? 4 pi, right? So here you will be having radiated power, that is 4 pi into radiation intensity of isotropic source, right? So now we have P radiated, that is equals to 4 pi into radiation intensity of isotropic source. And here this equation, that one can substitute in directivity equation. So if I say this is equation A, and let us say this is equation B, so we'll be substituting U ISO into equation A. So now modified equation of directivity will be how much? U divided by U ISO, that U ISO is P radiated divided by 4 pi, right? So here you can simplify this further. This 4 pi will go in numerator. So directivity will be 4 pi U divided by radiated power, right? So that is how one can identify directivity, that is 4 pi U divided by radiated power, where U is radiation intensity of given antenna, and P rad, that is radiated power by antenna, right? Usually we calculate maximum directivity, right? If you want to calculate maximum directivity, the reason is with directional antenna, in certain direction you will be having maximum directivity, and in other direction directivity will be less. So if you want to calculate maximum directivity, then you will be calculating that with respect to maximum radiation intensity, right? So for maximum directivity, equation is D max, that is equals to 4 pi into U max divided by radiated power, right? Using this equation, one can calculate directivity. Now, I'll solve one interesting problem that will resolve your further queries, like how to identify maximum directivity, right? So here, you can observe one problem is given in which we have unidirectional antenna and that is having radiation intensity, that is U is equals to Um cos theta, where theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2 and phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi, right? So what we will be doing is we will be using this directivity equation, right? So here maximum directivity that we will be going to calculate over here. So maximum directivity that I have derived right now, that is 4 pi into U max divided by radiated power, right? Now here in this equation, if you observe, we have U max, right? That is Um. So we need to identify radiated power based on this radiation intensity equation, right? So let us calculate radiated power. So if you want to calculate radiated power, then that is solid angle integration of radiation intensity, right? Now here, see, solid angle integration that you need to understand over here. So see, solid angle that will be having two components, theta and phi. Here theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2 and phi that is varying from 0 to 2 pi, and U is equals to Um cos theta. And one should know, see, this solid angle is what? Solid angle is sine theta d phi, right? This solid angle is sine theta d phi, right? Now we just need to do this integration. So here if you observe U of M, that is constant, just take it outside. And here we have cos theta sine theta, right? So if you do multiplication by 2 and divide it by 2, then here you can take by 2 outside, and inside you will be having 2 sine theta cos theta, that will be sine 2 theta, right? Now here, if you observe, see, this is sine 2 theta. So this function is independent on pi. So separately you can do integration, right? There is no dependency. So here Um by 2, that is constant outside, and integration of phi that is varying from 0 to 2 pi, that can be done separately. And here integration of this function sine 2 theta that is happening from 0 to pi by 2 sine 2 theta d theta, that can be done separately, as both of these functions are independent on each other, right? Now see, one integration, that is phi only, right, where limit is there from 0 to 2 pi, and sine 2 theta integration, that is minus cos 2 theta divided by 2, where limit is varying from 0 to pi by 2. Here if you substitute limit, then this is 2 pi only, and here we are having half into minus cos 2 theta into pi by 2. So that is minus cos pi. Minus cos pi is plus 1. Minus minus plus cos 0, that is again plus 1, right? So this 2 and this 2 is getting cancelled. This 2 and this 2 is getting cancelled. So this radiated power that we have calculated, that is pi into U of M, right? Now you see, we have radiated power, that is pi into U of M. So in this equation we can substitute, right? So now we can have maximum directivity, that is 4 pi into U max is how much? U of m, right? And radiated power that we have calculated, that is pi into U of m. So just do division over here, pi into U of m. So this pi U of m, that is getting cancelled, and we have directivity, that is 4 over here, right? Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.